So I just got back from vacation with some very close friends of mine. And when we went there, the main question people asked us was, why did you come to vacation in New York City from Florida? And honestly, the only answer I could give them was, it looked fun? This is our trip.
Is it alright if I come round? Is it too late if I come now? Will you stay up to figure this out some way? If I stay here, would you come back? If
I stay cool.
Please let that be vapor. After saying goodbye to two lovely ladies who gave me info on New York places and giving Karen shit for almost missing the shot I wanted.
You had one job, Karen.
Aw. Listen, I kept looking out the window like hoping it was gonna happen.
You were looking at your phone hoping it was gonna happen.
No, I kept looking out the window and all I kept seeing was freaking clouds.
We're on our way from LaGuardia Airport in Queens to our hotel in New Jersey. We dropped off our luggage, got a bus schedule, and rode the bus from the hotel into the city.
Man.
We had made it. We were finally in. Seriously, I've heard this song more times in New York than I ever have in my whole life. And I'm not even tired of it. Not at all. So people were telling me when we would first get to New York, we would probably experience culture shock. But honestly, I did. New York is busy in the best of ways. I didn't know where to look between the people and the huge advertisements and all the traffic and the huge buildings. My camera doesn't do justice to how big these buildings are. I'm talking looking up and almost bending over backwards to just see the top. These are the largest buildings I've ever seen in my whole life, especially seeing so many so close together. Everywhere had an advertisement. Everything was big. There were food stands on every corner that were almost exactly the same. We ended up walking 6 miles alone that day, just wandering aimlessly. Finally, after we got lost enough, we headed back to the hotel to get settled in because we got there too early and our room wasn't ready. Today we're taking a bus tour. The bus tour we chose takes you all over New York City. They even have deals like one free museum and extra hours on bike rentals, things like that. They also have audio recordings that play to tell you about where you're looking at and a few facts available in different languages. They even give you free headphones. The seats are first come first serve, but they have so many buses, if the top area is full, you'll for sure find another bus that will have seats very quickly. This is also the largest Macy's I've ever seen. It takes up a whole block. The bus tour was amazing. Seeing New York City this way is a must. Also, the fact that you can get on and off whenever really helped to see a lot of the city for cheap. At least as cheap as we could find it. Also, let me just say, New York architecture is amazing, but some things are questionable. Anyway, on the tour we saw the Empire State Building, and no, we didn't go in. We saw a few nice cathedrals, and did I mention the weather was beautiful in New York? Low 70s, no humidity, a dream come true, especially when you're from Florida. As we passed the Flatiron Building, New York serenaded us with its beautiful street music. This building, I don't know what it even is, but again, it looks amazing. The time for our first stop was approaching fast as the bus rolled through Chinatown. There was plenty of shops and restaurants. Oh, also, every restaurant in New York has their restaurant grade in the window. Great, right? We admired some more of New York's amazing architecture and Art before heading to the courthouse to take some pictures, hang out at their fountain, and have Karen reject me putting my camera on her. We also enjoyed our first New York hot dog. So we decided to head back to Chinatown in hopes of a place that had more shops. We thought we found that area, but it turned out to be Little Italy.
Little Italy?
No. Little Italy famous shops. And...
oh. Well, look. I guess we accidentally found it. Oh.
I know. It's like, how do you confuse Chinatown and Little Italy? Well, we're confused tourists. Like, cut me some slack, please. It felt nice not to have to worry about cars for a bit and walk in a more wide open area. Little Italy had a lot to offer in a small area. Hand-rolled cigars, gelato and Italian ice, cannolis of many different varieties. Small shops selling art, hats, bags, signs, shirts, fans, phone cases, sunglasses, fridge magnets, stickers, pendants, necklaces, bracelets, rings, you name it. Little Italy had it, and it was all at your convenience. There was an abundance of Italian restaurants too, 2 to 4 on every street. We walked out of Little Italy to see why there was such a huge crowd of people, to find a row of fruit stands, a wide assortment of fruit sold for pretty great prices. I grabbed a meat bun and some other snacks from a food store. It was filled with halal and caramelized onions, which is not normal, but it tasted great. We say goodbye to Chinatown and Little Italy. It was time to head back to the bus for our next stop. We were on our way to see one of the most iconic structures in New York, the Statue of Liberty. Before that, we had to get lost again though. After a friendly New Yorker pointed us in the right direction, we passed the park and some more sights of the city from afar. What part? I don't know. The park was cool though. They had ping pong tables, pool tables, basketball courts, an area to rent games and other things. Well worth a visit, but we didn't go. All that was left for us to do now was wait for our turn on the boat in about an hour and a half.
Some words are the same in English and French, you know? Telephone, salad, avocado. We don't use them on this tour. The river basically wanted to be controlled by the English. The English wanted the upper hand.
In the end, the boat tour wasn't what we thought it was going to be. We thought we were going straight to the Statue of Liberty to get off on the island and walk around, but we didn't. It ended up being perfect for what we wanted though. We did a loop and were told about some of the things we were seeing, saving the statue for last, of course, which also wasn't what we thought it was going to be. Shows and movies make the Statue of Liberty look huge, like a giant over New York. It's much smaller than we imagined, but nonetheless beautiful and still a must-see. After giving everyone ample time to take photos, the boat turned around and headed back to the city. After looking at our map, we saw the Twin Towers Memorial was close, so we headed there next. We passed the mall that oversaw the boat docks and crossed the street over to the memorial site. It's very well kept. The concept for the memorial was very serene, and the amount of names wrapped around the pools is chilling. You never know where life's going to lead you. Don't take every step of the way for granted. Do what you can, when you can. Overseeing the memorial is the World Trade Center. And off to the side is a building called the Oculus. It's apparently a $4 billion train station. Again, New York architecture. We decided we would head back to Times Square to get ready for the night tour. But later learned after waiting for 30 minutes, the last tour bus to get back to Times Square left 5 minutes ago. And the night bus doesn't come through here. So we decided to walk to another stop, hoping the night bus could pick us up. What ended up happening though was finding a pizza shop and proceeding to eat the best pizza we have ever tasted. New York style pizza is for sure a cut above the rest. Hands down, the best pizza. And New York style salads are aight. We ended up grabbing an Uber back to the bus station. It was late, we were tired, and the walk was way too far to get back soon.
Yeah, that was pretty cool.
We got to catch a glimpse of New York at night and headed back to the hotel to get ready for tomorrow's adventure.
No, you're good.
Oh, shit, you're too cool.